Alpha, beta and gamma radiation interact very differently with matter. Due to their large mass and charge, alpha particles are typically stopped very easily by as little as a few centimetres of air or a sheet of paper. Beta particles, being much lighter and only having a single unit of charge, need a few millimetres of aluminium before they're blocked. Gamma rays, on the other hand, have no mass or charge, so they can travel large distances and penetrate through significant amounts of material. This is one reason why detecting gamma rays is often the best way to detect the presence of radioactive material. Gamma rays interact with matter in three main ways. Pair production, when a high-energy gamma ray spontaneously decays to an electron-positron pair. Compton scattering, where the gamma ray bounces off an atomic electron, passing it some of its energy. And photoelectric absorption, where the gamma is fully absorbed by a tightly bound inner electron. Many traditional detectors use scintillators, which convert high-energy gamma rays into large quantities of lower-energy optical photons. A photomultiplier tube converts these photons to electrons and amplifies them to produce an electrical signal. From the amplitude of this signal and an understanding of how gamma rays interact in the detector, we can determine which radioactive isotopes are responsible for the radiation. These photomultiplier tubes are often large, bulky, and delicate devices requiring high-voltage power supplies, making them poorly suited to portable, wearable, or handheld detectors. Recently, researchers from York's Nuclear Physics Group, working with a technology company based in County Durham called Chromec, have developed an innovative new detector. They replaced the photomultiplier tube with a small semiconductor device capable of converting the optical photons directly to an electrical signal in only a few millimetres of silicon and requiring only a small battery to operate. Chromec have integrated this technology, along with a small neutron detector, into a wearable detector system, not much larger than a mobile phone. The detectors are networked, making it possible to build up a map of radiation within a large area. By distributing a large number of these portable devices across a group of people, such as a city's police force or postal service, it's possible to detect and monitor sources of dangerous radiation in real time. This device is a great example of how the research carried out here in York, in collaboration with local business and industry, is creating technologies that help to keep people safe all over the world.